I was asked today to talk to you a little bit about what we've called rebound. Sometimes, especially in the patients that we take care of here at CHR, women will take fertility medications, sometimes large doses of fertility medications, and we'll see no response. Now, this is obviously most common in people who are dealing with diminished ovarian reserve, premature ovarian aging, premature ovarian failure, and who attempt to do an ovulation induction using fertility medications. And we don't stop the fertility medications right away. Normally you take them for about 5 days. We check you. There's no response. We bring you back in 2 more days. No response. We bring you back 2 more days later. But after about a week or 10 days of taking these relatively expensive medications, it becomes clear that the medications aren't going to do anything. And most places at that point would just stop the medication and say, we'll try again another time. We noticed something interesting. We noticed that when we stopped these medications and saw people again in a few days, for some reason, follicles respond. And so an ovary that didn't have any follicular growth and no movement in its estrogen, which is one of the signs we see when the ovary is responding, so no increase in estrogen, all of a sudden, after 2 days or 3 days of not taking any medications at all, then the follicle begins to grow and the estrogen begins to rise. And we've seen this now repetitively among patients who have failed to have any response to medications. Recently, we reviewed our experience. I think there were about 40 people who would have qualified for this kind of rebound observation. And half of them actually began to respond and show follicle growth and elevated estrogen. When we've seen that, and normally we'll maybe bring them back one more time just to confirm that this is happening, we will restart some fertility medications, look for continued growth, and we've been able to bring these people to retrieval and get eggs and get to embryo transfers. Yeah, so at this point, there's maybe half of them, something like 20 people who have gotten to respond and produce follicles and produced eggs, and some of them have gotten to transfers. Now, with that small number, it's too small to say what the net effect of this will be. We have not yet had any pregnancies in this group, but the fact that we can get a response, that we can get embryos and get to transfer, suggests that given enough time and enough experience, we may well be able to get to pregnancy. Obviously, all of these are sort of long shot Hail Marys, but for people who are still committed to trying to achieve a pregnancy with their own eggs, it opens up another door, another pathway that we've been exploring. People sometimes ask us why, when I'm spending these thousands of dollars on medications to make my ovaries do something, why do they begin to respond when I stop the medications? And it's kind of interesting. We don't know exactly why, but we have some ideas. When they designed the fertility medications, they designed them to be like the hormones that are produced in menopausal women. And it turns out that the hormones that menopausal women produce, which were the traditional hormone that we used in years back, with the old-fashioned Pergonol, that those hormones are not as active as the hormones that a younger woman produces. They're actually chemically somewhat different, and they don't have as much effect. So it seems as though, at least in theory, that when we're giving the fertility medications, for a while your own body is sort of shuts down, suppresses, because we're providing the medicine from outside. But if that medicine is not effective and we stop it, then your body turns on again, starts producing its own gonadotropin, the fertility hormone, and that seems to be more effective than what you were injecting in yourself. And so that's what we think is going on, and we're trying to organize some testing to actually see how that changes in women as they go through their cycles. But that's an ongoing process. So anyway, that's what we know about Rebound. It's an interesting, relatively new way of approaching this problem. There are the alternative to this would be using somebody else's eggs, donor eggs. But for those of you who are not yet ready to take that step, this is one more little thing that we can do that has a possibility of getting you to an embryo transfer. And thank you for your attention. I hope this was helpful.